So welcome to the second round. I hope everyone is ready. So we are having a panel discussion. Gutenberg, which has been, you know, making his way to the WordPress. So let's first introduce the panelists who will be discussing about the same. So first we have Jaiman Pandya. Jaiman. So Jaiman is an independent UI UX designer and consultant, and he is based out in Mumbai. Next we have Mayur Keswani and Chirag Patel. They both are the project coordinators for Multidots based in Ahmedabad. Then we have Bhargav Mehta. He is an e-commerce developer at KrishaWeb, again in Ahmedabad. And Bhargav and Jaiman also volunteer at Getting Ready for Gutenberg project. Also, we have Amit Singh, who is the business owner at WPoets and also a developer. So, I would like them to come up to the stage so that we can have the session started. And how many of you have had the chance to look into it, experiment it? Okay, so for those of you who have not heard about it, actually Gutenberg in WordCamp Europe 2017, that gave us a very little brief of what Gutenberg editor would be. You know, and he showed us what are the possibilities and where the WordPress roadmap is going regarding the Gutenberg. So currently, Gutenberg is actually scheduled to be in three stages. Where it says currently we are heading to the phase one, where it will make into WordPress 5.0 into the core as a roadmap right now, and it will be introduced right. And right now it is sitting in the content space. So most of you would know that. We have a theme, then we have content section, we have sidebars, we have photos, widgets, meta boxes, many things. But right now, Gutenberg is about content editing, giving users the space to do more with the content that they are creating. So this is the phase one. So after the phase one completes, they have two more phases where they will be rigorously testing Gutenberg editor, taking the feedback from the community. That's why actually we are having this panel here. And then after the phase 3, it will be fully jammed between the in the WordPress. So let's start with the. So the first question that any user would have, most of you have used it, others have not. So the first thing is, how difficult do you think it would be for users to transition into Gutenberg editor? How hard it would be to convert from WYSIWYG editor that we have right now, TinyMCE? How many of you know about what we have in the content editor? We have TinyMCE. What you see, what you get is the interface. So we actually don't have take the full advantage of it, because what you actually see is not what you actually get. But Gutenberg aims to solve that thing. So how hard it would be to transition from a WYSIWYG editor, the experience that we have till now, till this length of time, to the Gutenberg editor? So if any one of you want to take this one, and yeah, sure.
Hello everyone. Can you hear me?
Yes.
So, question is, how difficult to transition to Gutenberg? Because they guys are used to with the classic editor, and they are guys used to with the existing plugins and theme. So, they gradually it works, and once the Gutenberg editor it comes in the markets, so then it works. So a bit difficult for the end users because their guys are used to with the existing themes and the plugins and the classic editor.
So I tell you my experience of when I first used Gutenberg, right? For writing blog or content, right? When I'm building a page, using a tool like Gutenberg makes it very, very easy, and I would love to use it for that scenario. But when I'm writing a blog, if the default editor is Gutenberg, then I have a very tough time figuring it out. That's what happened with me when I started the first time, and I saw the Gutenberg interface and I started like, you know, how do I write now a blog post? I was completely confused. So if someone like me, who has been working with WordPress and has seen Visual Composers and built and used them, gets confused when they see the first time that interface, I believe almost everyone will going to face that kind of a learning curve. So that's a challenge when we are looking at Gutenberg when it becomes the default.
For me, I would say that for end users, it will be an easy time once we have migrated completely to Gutenberg. The reason is there will be more training documents and more documents provided on the basis of Gutenberg, which a user or a blogger can read. And at the end of the day, they can easily learn and grasp the whole thing up and make something around it. So it will be easy for end users to migrate to, after migrating to Gutenberg. But from migrating to what you see is what you get editor to Gutenberg, it will be a tough task for them right now.
But yes, I had one thing to add with one thing is like Gutenberg is easy to learn. So as you said, gradually, that will be really helpful for all the bloggers. After gradually a quarter of a month or 2-3 months after. But this is, I think, a good thing.
Actually, I share a completely different opinion in terms of learning, because jis tarike se Gutenberg rollout ho raha hai, it is not rolling out. It's not that it's going to drop in at some point of time. The process is very gradual. There is a plugin jo aap test kar sakte ho. Also, the day it drops in, there is a classic editor plugin jise aap log sakte ho. You can do. So there would be a step-by-step process jisse people will adopt it, which will give them time to learn and understand. And people who are actually running sites, koi pagal nahi hai, nobody is going to say that aage Gutenberg daal do, meri site fatti hai to fatne do. Everybody is going to put classic editor.
Yeah.
You will have a staging environment. Us staging environment pe log pehle try karenge, seekhenge, apni teams ko train karenge. So adoption slow hoga, difficult nahi hoga. There is a difference between adoption difficulty and the speed of the adoption. So I feel the adoption is slow, but because Gutenberg kind of solves a lot of problems that current tiny actually does not, which one of the biggest is mystery meat. I don't know if you want to say mystery meat is the major issue of the current editor is getting solved. Can't hear? Minder? So I think the adoption would be slower and repeat and slower, but not difficult.
I have a question for you. Just an introduction, but kisi gaadi mein 4128 and 7090 that needs to be put to parking. Please parking. So, what are the rest? Okay, so far you discussed that if my Gutenberg RR has to be happy with it, thoda sa resistance hai. Because so time taking a scene, it is not actually the visual interface that I am used to, or many people here might be used to.
We actually don't have a visual interface.
Not actually. We don't even use visual interface. What you see, what you get. मैंने कभी use नहीं किया since I started using. But we call that visual editor. So that was the point. जैसा आपने बोला कि roll out होगा and there will be a transition period and something. Okay, we can go through that transition period. Many things have come that way कि अपने को पहले metaboxes भी था किसी को समझ नहीं आता था. Everyone is used to metaboxes and maybe use that. So what is the ऐसे क्या key points हैं जो user the end user who is creating the content, who has nothing to do with theme, who has nothing to do with even not even installing plugins, he just has to come to the blog and write the content. उनके लिए ऐसा क्या benefit है जिसकी वजह से उनको they should start giving feedback into Gutenberg, start using or getting used to Gutenberg. ऐसा वो क्यों करें? ऐसे क्या features हैं जो आपको लगता है Gutenberg solve करेगा जो अभी solve नहीं हो रहा है?
सिर्फ एक सबसे बड़ा feature जो मुझे लगता है, they can now basically customize the layout of a single post. That feature itself is big game. Like currently, if they have to create a blog or they want to write certain posts certain way, that's not possible without help of a developer friend. That will change. So that is one of the major advantages that I see once Gutenberg gets into the play. Of you will start seeing each post being different from another based on the actual content. Like this is how I want to show it, but because of the limitations that currently we have in the theme, we are not able to show it and we are living with it. I mean, we end up creating a lot of, as a company, like we've been creating a lot of tools for these bloggers ki bhi, achha tumko aise dikhana hai, to you do this way, do that way. That is something
the problem will completely go away.
So, one more thing I would like to add here. So, Gutenberg ने क्या chunk में divide कर दिया सारी page और कुछ we can say in the block. So वहाँ पे loader को specially Lenovo में workspace अच्छी मिलेगी. ये सबसे बड़ा उसका feature है. कहीं वो घूम नहीं जाएगा पूरे पेज के अंदर लोग खाएंगे. Workspace and environment उसको सही मिलेगा.
बेसिकली कोई भी अगर यूज़र होगा एंड यूज़र उसको जो दिखता है पीछे दिखता है राइट द सेम थिंग विल बी विजिबल ऑन द फ्रंट एंड राइट बाय यूजिंग गुटेनबर्ग तो वो जो हाउ द साइट इज डिजाइन इन द बैक एंड ही विल बी एबल टू सी इट इन द फ्रंट एंड सो वो उसको ज़्यादा आइडिया देगा एंड दे कैन इम्प्लीमेंट न्यू डिजाइन ओवर देयर एट द सेम टाइम और हर एक पेज को भी उसको अलग करना होगा ना देन ही विल बी एबल टू डू इट विद द सेम एडिटर नो कोड चेंज एंड अदर थिंग्स
एक्चुअली कभी भी योर क्वेश्चन इनको फीडबैक क्यों दे रहे हो मींस इन तीनों जो बोले ना इज एन अजम्पशन दैट द डेवलपमेंट टीम हैज मेड दैट दे वुड अंडरस्टैंड ब्लॉक्स दे वुड अंडरस्टैंड द वे दे कैन मेक और द वे नेस्टेड कॉलम्स माइट कम इन फ्यूचर सो दे वुड अंडरस्टैंड बट इट्स अ वेरी टॉल अजम्पशन बिकॉज आज के डेट में पेज बिल्डर भी वही करते हैं पेपर बिल्डर करता है वट एवर आई मीन आई वाज नॉट यू पेज सम अदर दे डू इट बट पीपल आर स्टिल नॉट एबल टू डेवलप देयर चेंजेस आज भी वो डेवलपर के पास आते हैं हमको एक पेज ऐसा ये बदलना है यहाँ पे ये विजेट डाल के डेवलपर को करना पड़ता है सो राइट नाउ देयर इज अ वेरी टॉल अजम्पशन कि गुटेनबर्ग में ब्लॉक आ गया तो हमारे पास ब्रह्मास्त्र आ गया वी कैन डू एवरीथिंग इससे शायद ना एंड to figure out the assumption right hai ke wrong hai end user ko feedback dena bahut zaruri hai the person who is blogging the person is not a developer jo code nahi likhta jo front end nahi likhta jo shayad sketch hai photoshop mein design nahi banata wo aadmi agar jaake feedback karta hai to usse pata chalega ki kya ho sakta hai kya nahi ho sakta and the feedback will be very simple you can go to github.com/wordpress/gutenberg.com you just look up and there is a you can when you are doing things you can just create an issue of that may kar raha aur ye waise nahi hua and just tell them that these are the steps that you are following and the best part about that GitHub issue tracking is that it is not only tracking development technical or design related issues it is actually a place to do the thinking where people are actually putting force that agar aise karte to शायद ऐसा होगा एंड देन देयर इज देयर अ लॉन्ग कन्वर्सेशन अबाउट द पॉसिबल थिंग्स दैट कुड
पीपल आर शेयरिंग डिजाइनर्स एज वेल कि क्या होना चाहिए
आल्सो नॉर्मल पीपल एक्चुअली इफ नॉर्मल पीपल गेट सो डेवलपर आएगा ठीक है डिजाइनर आएगा ठीक है जब तक एंड तक नहीं है ना उसकी सबसे ज्यादा वैल्यू एक्चुअली इट में इन द वर्ल्ड ऑफ गुटेनबर्ग सो इफ यू आर अ ब्लॉगर यू शुड स्टार्ट रीडिंग यू शुड आई नो गिटहब थोड़ा सा स्टार्टिंग में हैवी होता है मैं एज ए डिजाइनर मेरे लिए भी शायद में हेवी था बट इट्स प्रीटी सिंपल इश्यूज टाइम पे जाओ एंड स्टार्ट रीडिंग थिंग्स स्टार्ट डूइंग दोस थिंग्स इट विल हेल्प द कम्युनिटी एंड हेल्प यू एज एन एंड प्रोडक्ट बिकॉज इट इज गोइंग टू कम इट इज गोइंग टू
ओके सो ये फीडबैक की बात हो गई ये हो गई कि व्हाई अ पर्सन शुड यू नो स्टार्ट यूजिंग गुटेनबर्ग क्योंकि उसके अंदर ये सारी खूबियां हैं एंड मे बी वी शुड फोकस ऑन दीज की फीचर्स एंड स्टार्ट गिविंग द फीडबैक एंड एवरीथिंग But the end goal of Gutenberg, जो अभी तक जितनी presentations हुई like national में हुआ Europe में हुआ वहाँ से ये निकल गया है कि this is not the final goal of Gutenberg. The final goal of Gutenberg might be to sit all over WordPress, like including the content section, themes or a part, sorry, or sidebar part आ गया header footer. Initially what page builders per se are doing right now. So then there was a talk where it was said कि then page builders नहीं जाएंगे. Page builders would be like उस वो block उठाया और उस जगह रख दिया. ऐसे करके it would be an easy call. बट माई क्वेश्चन इज अभी आपने बोला कि यूजर को यूज टू आ रहा है तो फर्स्ट एंड फॉरमोस्ट बट वट आई कैन सी इज जो अभी की साइड अपनी बनी हुई है वर्डप्रेस में एवरीथिंग जिसमें यूजर कंफर्टेबल हो चुका है ऑलरेडी डोंट यू थिंक उसके अंदर वापस सोफिस्टिकेटेड अपने को काम करना पड़ेगा जिसके हिसाब से अगर इफ दे चेंज समथिंग यूजिंग द गुटेनबर्ग एडिटर फॉर समथिंग तो उन वो चीज़ें इंकॉर्पोरेट हो सकें लाइक यू आर द प्रोजेक्ट कोऑर्डिनेटर्स यू माइट नो दैट बहुत सी साइट्स ऐसी हैं जो वनीला उस पेज पर बनती है क्योंकि फाइन आपको ऐसे प्यार पाँच प्रोग्राम लिखना है छठा आपका कॉर्डिनेटर है कि साथ ऐसा हो जाएगा तो एटलीस्ट इन एशियन सिनेरियो वेयर द एंड यूजर इज नॉट दैट एक्टिव ऑन द डैशबोर्ड और द part of it. Bloggers, even bloggers are you know, following the same set of protocols. Okay, my paragraph or paragraph hai, left my image, right my image, that's it. उस सिनेरियो में ट्रांजिशन टाइम ज़्यादा नहीं होना चाहिए था. लाइक वी आर ये तो 5.0 में आएगा, उससे पहले का ये जो टाइम है मिलेगा, जब तक यूजर ये एक्सप्लोर करेगा कि मैं ऐसे ऐसे कर सकता हूँ, तब तक डेवलपर्स ऑल्सो हैज़ टू रश के या तो थीम के अपग्रेड करेंगे या फिर जो प्रोजेक्ट्स अपन बनाते हैं उन प्रोजेक्ट्स को अपने को रिवैम्प करना पड़ेगा. इसके ऊपर आपको क्या होगा, बिकॉज यू गाइस मैनेज द प्रोजेक्ट्स एज़ वेल एंड वी हैव डेवलपर्स. सो व्हाट डू यू वांट टू से अबाउट दैट?
यस, बेसिकली यू नो 5.0 आल्सो बोला है, 5.0 आया है. तो उसमें गूगल पर किसी बाई चॉइस इसलिए बाई फोर्स नहीं है. सो आफ्टर वन ईयर ऑफ यू नो लाइक मैट फिट है, आफ्टर वन ईयर दैर विल बी यू नो वेरी बिग चेंज इन द गूगल पर स्कोर, इन बटर स्कोर, राइट? सो बेसिकली यस सर, इस पर आई नो इस पर माय ओपिनियन लाइक वी हैव वी बीन लाइक सो मेनी प्रोजेक्ट इन बटर, राइट? वी यूज द कस्टम बिल्ड मेटाबॉक्स एंड ऑल द थिंग्स. Like we build theme plugin and all. But after building the theme, we have to implement the project, you know, compatible with Gutenberg, and definitely we have to, you know, do some custom functionality over there.
It will take a longer curve for you to deliver the project and make sure that it works. Actually,
yeah,
works
of
with the help of Gutenberg. Yes. Yeah,
so basically, we will be not activating the default Gutenberg for our customer sites that we maintain. We'll basically wait for customer to become familiar with it, get used to it, and we'll slowly, very slowly, we'll be going slower than what WordPress.
Okay. Yeah, because it depends on user,
we have a
very
different
perspective of
the
user, right?
So we have that kind of made up our mind on the rollout of Gutenberg that it will be very slower than what WordPress is. It will be slower than that.
Okay, so
So, if we are talking about the time, so whatever plugin is already introduced in the software, already we have a 6 to 7 months. So, as Remy said, we have to realizations, implementations, deployment, and then adaptation. ये चीज़ अपने में आनी चाहिए, वो आनी होगी ना? क्योंकि मैंने तो बहुत सीरियसली बोल दिया था यूरोप में कि ये आनी ही वाली चीज़ है. मैं एंड यूज़र के लिए सोचा हूँ. वो अपने के अंदर रियलाइजेशन आना चाहिए. पॉलिटिक्स ने प्लगिंग के फॉर्म में दे दिया.
द बेसिक क्वेश्चन दैट आई मे बी आई एम नॉट एबल टू एक्सप्लेन इट विल अभी हो जाएगा. कंटेंट एडिटर वी विल हेल्प आवर कस्टमर्स एंड एवरीथिंग, यू नो, एक्सप्लेनिंग देम ओके फाइन द वे यू आर राइटिंग लॉग कैन नाउ बी रिटन इन दिस वे. आप ऐसे लिख सकते हैं, आप ऐसे लिख सकते हैं. जब ये फुल फ्लैज हो जाएगा, यस वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द फ्यूचर, बट जब ये फुल फ्लैज हो जाएगा व्हेन गुटेनबर्ग विल बी विद अदर एटीट्यूड्स एज वेल, कि आप ये भी कस्टमाइज कर सकते हो वो सर. उस टाइम आपको नहीं लगता है कि वो बहुत ओवर वैल्यू हो जाएगा? वी शुड हैव सेपरेटेड इट.
नहीं, एक्चुअली नहीं.
आई हैव एन एनालॉजी फॉर यू.
ओके,
इन 1986 द कार्स हैड अ स्टीयरिंग व्हील, अ हॉर्न एंड अ गियर व्हील एंड क्रैंक व्हील्स. टुडे योर कार डज नॉट हैव स्टीयरिंग कंट्रोल. जैसे इसमें स्टीयरिंग कंट्रोल नहीं है, इसमें रिवर्स सेंसर नहीं है, इसमें कैमरा नहीं, ऐसा कैसे गाड़ी हो, इसमें कुछ नहीं है, मतलब राइट? सो दैट्स द एनालॉजी, राइट? आज की डेट में हमारा वर्कर्स हमको ये बता देता है कि कुछ जो नहीं है.
सी बट इन योर एनालॉजी, जैसा बोल रहे हैं कि कार के डैशबोर्ड में वो सब नहीं था. व्हेन दे स्टार्टेड डूइंग इट, दे उन्होंने लाइन मैन्युफैक्चर कर दिया. आई वाज बाइंग अ कार, ओके मेरे पास आ गया, इसको करते हैं कैसे, नहीं हो गया, इसको करके देखा यूज. आई हैड टू यूज इट बिकॉज आई परचेज्ड इट. WordPress is more of choice के मैंने अच्छा फाइन मेरे को ऐसे करने की आदत है.
But lot of places, see, lot of places we are already making people do things certain way. Right? What Gutenberg is doing basically is standardizing those way of doing things. So basically, I don't think that will become overwhelming per se. It will become more a standardized way of using it, and soon people will become familiar. It's like this. Once you become familiar over a period of time, you will learn to use it. Then you will wonder again, कि पहले कैसे होता था? जैसे नहीं था.
And everyone would be doing the same thing, so
yes.
It would be easier to solve.
And the point is, you don't have a choice here also. You have to use a similarly. You have to use the WordPress.
Yeah.
Or you have to move out of WordPress.
Yeah, exactly.
And you know how that territory is.
Yeah, because right now what is happening is people have very strong opinions about both of the things. Yes, Gutenberg, no Gutenberg, or something.
Once it goes live, then that debate will be redundant. Then people will figure out a way to increase the adoption, right? like for example, like he said, you know, it's been out for a long time, but internally I have not yet started actively playing with it because I don't want to play with a beta version of something that will go away or might not even come out in the picture. I'd rather wait for it to come to production, mature it a little more time, and then I will start adopting for my customers because, you know, giving something halfway or too early to use can backfire for my customers and my business.
But I think every customer has their own feedback system, I guess. Because other SME had this problem.
See, most of the time we have to sell the feature.
Yeah, so I have like a completely different opinion than this. So we recently I made a website for a client of mine. And many of the site booting up, I have told them, ye fatega, kisi bhi point mein fatega. So but many of the site booting up, it gives me two reasons. मेरे को चार महीने बाद वो साइड वापस नहीं करनी आई एम डन इट डेल विद दैट टाइम आई डोंट गो बैक टू दैट मैंने आज साइड करके डाल आई मेंटेनिंग दैट मेंटेनेंस ब्रिंग्स मी मनी आई एम क्लियर क्लाइंट भाई आज से यूज कर रहा ना देखो आज से देखो अगले 10 साल के लिए वर्डप्रेस में यही यूज करना है दिस इज द रोड मैप राइट यू हैव टू यूज टू मेंटेन दिस यू गॉट टू बी एक्स मोर मनी मैं पैसा भी आ रहा है आई एम ट्रेनिंग माय क्लाइंट वेरी एडवांस and I'm not doing any of it. So I think that actually, my parents didn't say it because
I think what you say
is that I'm a conservative. That's what I'm saying. I'm a conservative. I'm a conservative. I'm a conservative.
So main thing was that the feeling and the realization, jo sense aata na chahiye na ki road map hai, isko use karna chahiye, wo apne public mein lana
community.
Even jo main hai, wo khud bol raha hai ki ye main lana ka plan kar raha hu. कोर में डालने का प्लान कर रहा हूँ वो एक सीरियसनेस है ना वो पब्लिक में आने
की एग्जैक्टली एंड आई विल आल्सो एनकरेज एनीवन इफ हैज क्वेश्चंस तो आप पूछ सकते हैं सो दिस हैज द यूजर पार्ट ऑफ यस यू हैव
वाज स्कूटर फॉर रियली नीडेड
यस यस सी आई टेल यू फ्रॉम माय बिजनेस पर्सपेक्टिव राइट देयर आर सो मेनी पेज बिल्डर्स आउट देयर राइट नाउ व्हाट वर्डप्रेस रियली नीड इज अ स्टैंडर्डाइज्ड वे ऑफ डूइंग द थिंग्स See, as a developer, right, I build stuff. And for me to actually make it easier to give it to my customer, I don't want to integrate with 10 other page builders, right? Because I don't know which one my customer will end up using. But with Gutenberg, that problem goes away for me as a business side of the story. On the user side of the story, see, ability to customize pages, ability to build everything on my own. See, the template part of Gutenberg that is coming in, right, reusable blocks. Once this happens, you do understand the, I don't know if you guys understand the potential of that, but what it means is your customer will start, after you've done with the thing, they will start using those things to create their own pages without your help. This is very, very big thing, and if this does not happen, I mean, this was going to happen. If it is not Gutenberg, someone else would have done it. It's better to be Gutenberg and a standardized
workflow. Your question is like, I want to get out of this loop, and do I need the door? I don't know, I need a swiveling door or a rotating door, but I do need a door. The answer is Gutenberg, personally, yes, we don't know, but the first proposal is Gutenberg, and it is working for us. So there is nothing wrong with it. So the question that do we need to, is Gutenberg the answer? Maybe, may not be. They might, that's how software development is, right? You build something and then you pivot to something and then you build something based on feedback, right? So there is a possibility, I'm not saying that it would happen, there is a possibility that Gutenberg would change completely, or there is a possibility it's going to go out exactly the way it is, right? But that depends on the time. So Gutenberg is the answer, Gutenberg, but yeah, standardization is the answer. That is the goal that they are trying to achieve.
Also, if you see, many page templates are created in a single page website, single website, right? So to eradicate those, for each type of layout, we need to create another page template from the developer. To eradicate those things, Gutenberg is coming up with a standard format that, okay, you need only one template and in that you can fit in anything you want.
Any more questions? Okay, you have a question.
So there is a theme already in on the WordPress repository, which is having Gutenberg CSS and other block types, which are by default given by Gutenberg, and those CSS are CSS, JavaScripts, and other things are written over there. So you can of course integrate any framework you wish to integrate. CSS framework you wish to integrate, like Bootstrap, Foundation, anything.
But like page builder, so using a four, three, four, and any other classes in Gutenberg.
So yes, there are classes written. There is a section, full element section written over in the Gutenberg, which gives you facility to divide your content in columns, rows, and other things.
And compulsory addition in
4.5.0.
Yes, it is going to release in 5.0.
And content replaced to Gutenberg.
No, you will have an option. You will have an option to switch between classic editor and Gutenberg editor. But it is good. यहाँ पे भी यही बोलना चाह रहे हैं कि it is more good अपन जितना जल्दी we get used to it, because so that we can start designing
solutions.
हाँ, तो Gutenberg अभी Gutenberg content section के अंदर है. Gutenberg theme के ऊपर नहीं गया है.
Header footer पे नहीं.
Header footer.
So basically Gutenberg is your page builder for now.
जो TinyMC अपन use कर रहे हैं.
तुम्हारा WordPress के अंदर the underscore content में आता है. वो है तुम्हारा अभी Gutenberg is the underscore content. That's the permission. That is what Gutenberg is. बाकी आपका you can do whatever you want. Plus आप जो बोल रहे हो ना that I want to use Bootstrap or whatever, it doesn't limit you. You can use Bootstrap to build your blogs and everything, right? You can do that.
जैसा अभी तक अपन करते हैं कि Bootstrap अपन include कर देते हैं and everything, you can still do that. But ऐसा कोई inclusion नहीं है Gutenberg के अंदर कि वो included.
It's the same thing that we enqueue your scripts and styles. जैसे आज करते हो, अब ऐसे ही तब भी करो।
Any more questions? Yeah.
WordPress is taking care of all the security patches are applied or not.
Code standards available, but it's a zaruri nahi ki sare bug pakde jate hain, something slips through. Agree, and that is why. And also by the nature of the volatility, jis speed pe kaam chal raha hai, it early or production mein much use karo.
My suggestion is like, maine today ATM team ke saath baat ki thi, wo specific bug bounty program.
Yeah.
आप वर्ल्ड वाइड फॉर्म करो सिक्योरिटी पर हैकरों के सामने,
वो फाइंड करके आपको दे एंड आप स्वेयर किया स्पेसिफिक कम्युनिटी उसको प्रोवाइड करें।
मैं वो अभी अभी बहुत वोलेटाइल है, नेचर उसका बहुत बीटा है, बहुत काम चल रहा है,
जिन्होंने Gutenberg यूज नहीं किया है, सो थीम होती है, एवरीवन नोस दैट देयर इज अ हेडर, देयर इज अ फुटर, देयर इज अ साइड बार एंड देयर इज कंटेंट, राइट? एवरीवन, इफ समवन हैज एनी कंफ्यूजन इन दैट, ओके, सो अभी करंटली Gutenberg इज इन द कंटेंट पार्ट, टाइटल, सबटाइटल, कंटेंट, इमेजेस जो अपन डाल रहे हैं, द कंटेंट डेवलपर भाषा में, द अंडरस्कोर कंटेंट जो अपन फेच करते हैं और जहां के लिए लिखा जाता है एडिटर के अंदर आके, तो दैट पार्ट वुड बी रिप्लेस्ड बाय Gutenberg। उस टाइम भी अपने पास एक लंबे ट्रांजिशन पीरियड के लिए ऑप्शन होगा ऑफिस पीछे जाने का, क्लासिक एडिटर यूज करने का, बट करंटली वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द Gutenberg व्हिच इज इंप्लीमेंटेड ऑन दैट पार्ट व्हिच इज फेज 1। तीन फेजेस हैं अभी करंटली, फेज 1 चल रहा है। सो अभी इस लैंग्वेज के बाद में डू वी हैव एनी अदर क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम द पैनल? ओके, सो ये ओनली फर्स्ट यूजर यूज केस है, द यूजर्स का यूज केस कैसा आएगा, बीइंग प्रोजेक्ट कोऑर्डिनेटर्स एंड डेवलपर्स योरसेल्फ एंड द बिजनेस ओनर, सो there are many languages, not many, but there are bunch of languages and technologies that we need to use अगर मैं कुछ develop करना चाहूँगा कोई बोलता हूँ, right? And वो अलग है, it's not just PHP or CSS obviously. तो PHP और JS vanilla इसके हिसाब से नहीं कर पाएंगे, तो के कौन सी वो चीज़ें हैं जो एक developer और a company और an agency who is starting with WordPress development or who are doing still doing are in the business and want to be in the Gutenberg bandwagon, वो कैसे कर सकते हैं, वो कौन सी टेक्नोलॉजीज हैं जो सीखनी पड़ेगी और उनको चालू कैसे करना, बिकॉज आई थिंक देयर आर मेनी पीपल स्टार्टिंग अप विद द बॉयलर प्लेट्स एंड एवरीथिंग, तो क्या सही तरीका है इसको चालू करने का, कौन सी टेक्नोलॉजीज है दैट यू थिंक वुड प्ले अ क्रूशियल रोल और की रोल इन स्टार्टिंग विद Gutenberg?
सो बेसिकली फॉर स्टार्टिंग विद Gutenberg, यू Gutenberg इज कंप्लीटली बेस्ड ऑन द नेक्स्ट ईएस नेक्स्ट व्हाट वी से, it is not ES5 or ES6 completely, it is based on ES Next. So for starting up learning Gutenberg or starting up development in Gutenberg, first you need to clear your JavaScript basis. I'm sure how many of you have clear JavaScript basis? JavaScript basis concept clear is here,
please raise your hand.
Sure.
Very few, right? So उनको पहले JavaScript basics clear करने पड़ेंगे, that is a learning curve जो आपको follow करना पड़ेगा to basically clear what Gutenberg wants to build inside and what is running behind Gutenberg, right? So उनको वो clear करना पड़ेगा, so that they can learn React also. And after learning React and ES6, they can jump into Gutenberg completely.
We have to learn JavaScript, then ES6 plus, then React, and then after that definitely there are so many people are developing a boilerplate, right? And I saw that the boilerplate code and all, but definitely that you have to create a simple block, then you have easily created this block, but if you want to add some property on that, then you must have to knowledge about the React.js. So I suggest for a WordPress developer the React.js is required.
So it's like so I'm a designer, so iska code maine nikalne ka koshish kiya tha, I'm not very good at JavaScript and I'm not very good at PHP. So जब पहले वर्डप्रेस डेवलपमेंट करते थे तो इट वॉज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड टू बी एन एक्सपर्ट एट PHP, यू नीडेड टू नो हाउ टू राइट द सिंटैक्स ऑफ PHP, हाउ टू रीड द सिंटैक्स ऑफ PHP, कुछ अच्छे अच्छे फंक्शन बनाए थे दो चार रूप से, और
if you are able to traverse through those functions and hooks and actions, you can build a WordPress theme, right? आज तक ऐसा होता था. इस चीज में मुझे ऐसा लगता है that even what Gutenberg team has done, they have used React as the base, but उन लोगों ने React के ऊपर एक abstraction layer लिखा, which is the WP object. So if you learn that WP object instead of learning the whole React, you can get started with Gutenberg. You will not be a very good team developer or a Gutenberg developer, but you will be able to make your way through, and then you can get into learning React, SQL, जो भी आगे और बढ़े वो सब बाद में सीख सकते हो. बट इफ यू वांट टू गेट योर हैंड्स डर्टी, यू कैन लर्न द एब्स्ट्रैक्शन लेयर. उसका उसके लिए कुछ कोर्सेज है ऑनलाइन के, यू कैन अहमद अवाइस कम विद द बॉयलरप्लेट, इट्स एन ओपन सोर्स बॉयलरप्लेट, यू कैन टॉक अबाउट इट हियर. इट्स कॉल्ड क्रिएट गुटेन ब्लॉक, यू कैन लुक एट इट. एंड द गिटहब, सो देयर इज अ हैंडबुक, गुटेनबर्ग हैंडबुक, बट वो मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम आउटसोर्सिंग होती है. So you can actually go to GitHub and you can read. There is a README file in every section, and you can read that README file. That is pretty much every course online. जो आजकल ऐसा लेके सिखा रहा है. All of those courses are pretty much teaching you those README files. So if you don't want to spend money, you can. Or there are really good people who are teaching you in a simple layman's language. You can learn the abstraction layer through those courses. But you can get started with Gutenberg after going from here. Between the WordCamp and the Afterburner, इतना ही दिक्कत है. There is a 2-hour gap, I think, between the WordCamp and Afterburner. You can start working with Gutenberg when you learn that abstract layer in those tools. और उसके बाद तो हाँ, as they said, you have to learn React, you have to learn ES Next, ES whatever other things are called.
So basically, Gutenberg बनाना है या Gutenberg में blocks बनाने हैं? You have two different things,
right?
And both require different skill sets.
Right. So, सारी technology term के पहले मतलब, I think पहले आपने वो admin demo एक बार देखा.
Voice.
Yes. So yes.
और last में यार अपनी session generally तो बता रही है, ऐसे entry operator.
Yeah. Not issue. So my point is that because in technical terms we should aware about the admin's demo. Many features are available in the admin side.
Hello.
Can you hear me?
Yeah.
So my point is that I think we should first aware about the admin panels and the demo side. Then we should start the technologies and JavaScript and React.
Yeah. So we'll try after we wrap the event and before what Afterburner begins, we'll have a small 20-minute session where Jaiman or someone from the group can show how the Gutenberg works in the state it is right now. So if anyone is interested, we can do that. So I had one question. You said creating Gutenberg and creating Gutenberg blocks is two different scenarios and two different skill sets. So what are, if you can briefly explain, what are the skill sets that you need?
So learning to work, create the Gutenberg, right? Building and patching will require a lot of skills. PHP, React, Core JavaScript, everything in between, right? But creating the block, the boilerplate, will basically abstract most of it, this knowledge out for you. So all you need to do is one of the building blocks like that Avicii has released, right? Either that or WP object that they are talking about, right? Once you learn that, you will be able to create the blocks. And I mean, the way I say it, it's matter of time because there are all the blocks that you need are already created, and all you need to learn is basically using those blocks. How to combine those blocks, that's about it. So skills per se, it will be more important from my perspective is to understand how these blocks work and to be able to style them, right? Then actually create those blocks. Because there are only so many set of layouts you will be able to create. After that, it is like repetition.
Yeah,
so
I think that again opens the challenge of styling. Probably the situation sort of state where everything is styled.
And this will zoom right along in a matter of months, it will be over. Because almost everyone has, guys who have created these blocks in various page builders, I mean, it's on their business if they do not immediately support the Gutenberg. So the day Gutenberg goes live, there will be hundreds of specifically created blocks that will go live. So learning to create blocks now is already too late, as far as I'm concerned. Like, learn, but it's better to now take advantage of what people have already learned and created, learn to implement them, because that's where there will be a bigger gap, skill gap that will happen, is how to implement those blocks that these guys have created, how to configure them. Basically, the major job is to configure these blocks than actually creating these blocks.
शेर का सामान लेके जाना था यू नेवर नो द टाइगर वुड बी देयर इन द वाइल्ड राइट सो आई बिलीव दैट यू शुड लर्न टू बिल्ड द ब्लॉक्स यू विल ऑटोमेटिकली नो हाउ टू इंटीग्रेट ब्लॉक्स सो दैट इज
दैट इज आई कैन टेल यू इट्स नॉट द केस पीपल हु राइट कोड नेसेसरली डोंट नो हाउ टू कॉन्फिगर दैट सेम थिंग
आई मीन दिस इज जस्ट टू ओपिनियंस
माय एक्सपीरियंस इज कंप्लीटली
या
जस्ट
टू
वेरी लास्ट As we are talking about blocks, so that naturally brings in the topic of plugins and themes and all. I have not actually used Gutenberg for that longer period of time or jump in a feedback based or something. But what I believe is it true that Gutenberg can say widgets would be less, yeah, the plugins would adapt in a way to blocks provide rather. Just for example, I was talking to authentic people as well that I saw a demo somewhere where Jabi Aayega Gutenberg would be full pleasure team to the system. WooCommerce would be starting with the product blocks of that. So you will start getting blocks like you are currently getting text blocks. Then I can imagine a scenario where EDB would be the same story. Everything would be
all of them.
So how do you think this Gutenberg, this block system that we are introducing in the WordPress would change the plugin scenario or the theme scenario, the businesses around it? Like you guys have dealt with sites which are for businesses and you.
So I'll tell you. See, the move is towards Lego based systems. If you have played around with Legos, what this Gutenberg basically brings in mainstream is Lego based development. What will happen is a lot of people will create tools for you to create those blocks. So you have the blocks, right? The need to create one more block is basically going to reduce. Like after a certain period, creating one more block that is exactly the same thing has no value. The value is in the spinning of those blocks. The theme business, I don't think it will get affected. Plugins business, again, what they are doing is still the valid area of their work. It's still, you know, see, so Gutenberg is basically creating what you, I will say is UI blocks. So what you are basically doing is at some stage it will become a site builder from just a page builder. And at that point it's how you and the theme, how themes skin the these blocks will win the game in that longer run. So the game would be skinning those blocks, because creating the blocks, all these big guys, whoever have the UI chunks, any plugin or theme that gives you a UI chunk will give you a block for it, out of box. Like that is, has to be there, or they die. Either they do this or they die. There is no middle ground here, right? So assume karo ki almost jitne bhi plugins already hain, un sab ke UI blocks ko tumhe milenge. So if you are creating a plugin that is already a gap, you have a need for that plugin. So it won't affect the plugin per se, but every plugin will now have to give you a UI block if they want their adaptability to increase. Because what is going to happen is, end user, see, this is something that I've been kind of working with for the last few years with WordPress, or at my company, is end user is going to build their own sites. Once end user starts building their sites, they only need help in certain parts. One of those would be skinning. They will not need you to create the site anymore, because if by drag and drop seekh liya na, to phir wo kuch bhi bana sakte hai kyunki wo already available hai. It's a problem of learning. Learning ka problem bhi kyun tha? Because there were so many different things to learn. But with Gutenberg, that will standardize. So once that happens, the game is spinning. So themes business is still going. It's not going to happen.
But plugin business would.
Plugin will adopt. So they all have to give the blocks.
Yeah.
But affect, nothing will affect. I mean, Gutenberg is not displacing anything. The space for a new feature is still there. The space for a new feature is still there.
But as it is said, right? You know, 12-13 years ago, Metamoxel, I said, look, you know, shit, now WordPress is going to go down the drain and all sorts of things. But which are, today, can you imagine a website without Metamoxel? You know,
first, I have to start with
exactly. So, Gutenberg is kind of doing the same what happened with Metabox, which is actually
the only experience, there are still not limited, the only experience I have with plugins is just when we made a site getting ready for Gutenberg, we use Calendra forms, a Gutenberg, Calendra forms is not Gutenberg, so we use that plugin. And the form that you see on the site is generated through a Gutenberg blog of Calendra forms. And I remember using another plugin Pellet, and I will tell you the truth. I was never ever able to figure out the email functionality working in the first time. I had to reuse it a few times. Everybody knows what I'm talking about, but I'm not going to use it. But when we did this blog functionality, everything was so nicely segregated. My blog is going to look like this. It was there in one part, and my settings are there in the other part, which is under the panel on the right side.
Yeah, blog.
And then all the settings are so nicely set up. It was so nicely segregated that the setup was a breach. I mean, it did not even take us 2 minutes to do
the
site. We did within 2 minutes, under 2 minutes, set up two forms of the site.
Important for them to make it compatible with Gutenberg. And they have to invest their time on running on it. It will, in the end, it will decrease the efforts of end user how to use a plugin or how to use a theme.
So, let's talk about that scenario only. So, if we have plugin people like, we can say, if we have plugin team, then we have used, we have a team, great plugins, with a great team. Okay, so instead of, I can be in the first in line to get those blocks level. But there was, specifically, I just remembered a plugin, this P2P connect, or something P2P, which connects one post to another post. We used to use that. Just say, I believe it's two, or someone was the developer, and he said that I'm not able to support it, this plugin anymore, and I believe this is what happened. So that plugin is right now absolutely, you have to use it on your own. So, don't you think this Gutenberg scenario would push, obviously push for plugin developers to get compatible with blocks, block in the latency and functionality because of everyone would be using Gutenberg. So, who plugin developers who are sole developers, someone who is, buddy skill can even write this plugin. Don't you think we'll lose much of that juice, that good options and plugins and everything that we have? Because MetaOps is an addition to an already existing interface. We get used to, apne base pe humne used to hoga MetaOps se, then we start taking use of them and appreciating them. Gutenberg would be completely changing the scenario. Yes, we are getting used to it, but it will change the scenario. So, us time tak, un plugins ka kya, jo, ya to
right? New opportunities for new people.
Yeah, that and feature. Then, guys, have to yeah, that is what I'm saying.
But if they can't do that, that's why we came up with this thing where we came up with a site which is getting ready. If you cannot support your plugin or you want help importing your plugin, which you don't have the right words.
You can help your community.
That's what we're trying to do here. We're trying to help, and we're also calling for developers. Okay? So, my first free time is 2 minutes, you can put in the blog if you want that. Please spend your time, 2 hours, to build that plugin for someone else. And that's how the WordPress community
works actually.
So when people say that Gutenberg added a plugin while it was time developer, the responsibility actually does not lie on the shoulders of the plugin developer. The responsibility lies on the shoulders of the community, and which is why the plugin repository is open.
And still, as I said, right, once Gutenberg goes live, there is a race that is gonna happen. People who fall behind will fall behind. So this, I actually don't think
it actually doesn't go with the community statement that someone falls behind, but they are giving a very good amount of time.
The idea is fall back. Like you said, like I cannot support, no matter what community gets to me, right? I cannot support. I am visiting something else, I have moved on to something else. Right? I am not interested in
that. Just because of Gutenberg rolling out and if I am not able to support.
So, I am
not really worried about things or the gap, because the gap will be very, very small.
So buying and adoption is an ability in the
community.
People buy some
plugins. Also, one more thing, WordPress community is running a Tide program in which all the plugins, right, there is a Tide channel on Slack where all the plugins which are not supported are being deprecated and are being removed of the from the WordPress repository. So they are working on it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So
that
kind of learning
can
WordPress.
So actually people who want to get into plugins can actually look at the report of the type and the plugins which are not getting developed, pick them up, maybe write to the developer, adopt those plugins and start working.
Also in type they are doing code checks and other things. If code is compatible with all the versions, it's okay if it is not maintained or if there is no support request for that. Also they are running mini tests on it.
Type. Maybe you can. So WordPress has this Slack channel, जहाँ की बात होता है, उसके ऊपर देख सकते हैं. So if you can read the what this channel is about. And
so anyone who is having a WordPress.org account, how many of you are aware of Slack? How to use Slack? So all are aware, right? So WordPress.org has its own Slack channel where anyone having a WordPress profile can join. There are that is wordpress.slack.com, right? In that there are 100 many channels for each contribution, right? There is a core editor channel where there is a discussion going on Gutenberg. There is core channel where there is a work going on WordPress core where bugs and patches are updated over there on that channel. Discussion over there goes on. There is marketing channel where marketing. So it is kind of all the contribution channels are there over on wordpress.slack.com. Anyone can join. And in that there is a channel named Tide where this discussion is going on of plugins and plugin repository.
Okay, so we have like 10 minutes left. So let's say one community question. So how everyone here is a WordPress user in one or another. So according to you guys, how they can give their feedback, how they can contribute in the Gutenberg project to make it a success. So if you can tell them a few ways in which we all can take part in it.
Yeah, Gutenberg contribution, there will be two ways. One is, GitHub repository, and the second one is, WordPress, that will be our page, that Gutenberg, like SVN. So there will be two repositories where you can, contribute on Gutenberg.
You want to say something, sir?
Yes, one more thing, Mate's own blog is available for the Gutenberg. We can also provide the feedback on the Mate's blog. So, if you are talking about the feedback, we can provide the feedback on the Mate's blog.
The best way to give feedback is to install Gutenberg on a site, use it, find issues, and post it on GitHub.
Posting GitHub does, WordPress the power there.
If you cannot code, find issues. आज के रेट में तुम्हारी वैल्यू ज़्यादा है रखने का जरिया। That's how you'll be able to build a better software. So that is the best way to contribute. But there are other areas like documentation is lacking behind. So if you understand how Gutenberg is working and if you're good with words, आप जाके documentation लिख सकते हो। If you are good at marketing, if you are good at content creation, if you are good at digital, you can go to marketing channel. You can reach out to people like Bridget Williams and everything. And help create resources for Gutenberg. We are trying to build videos, we are trying to build courses, written courses on the adoption of Gutenberg. You can contribute that way. You can go to, if you are good at design, you can look at the design issues and fix or help them fix design issues. So contribution in Gutenberg is exactly like contribution in WordPress. You don't have to be a developer to contribute. You can do 10 other things. Other way of contribution is maybe when you go to WordCamp or when you go to media, talk about Gutenberg. Tell people about what Gutenberg is. Initially aisa hota hai, this is the who moved my cheese effect right now. Ke yaar ye kya bol diya, ye kaise hoga, pata nahi samajh mein nahi aata, right? But eventually everybody will fall in place. So look at it with an open mind. Understand how things are happening. And if you understand, you teach two more people, in the community. Actually, we have a lot of bulk volume production, and we have a lot of Gutenberg as a positive child. But community people are people who are growing. Maybe you can talk to them, you can explain how to get it. And if you have a church, you will also be considered as a contribution. But you have a bad name. But yeah, that is also a kind of contribution. You can, like Monica did some kind of contribution where you could text bold, which you didn't see, 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 you didn't see. But we will not remark to that.
Using the React and the ES6.
And as far as I know, drag and drop is only limited to what works right now, dragging and dropping media.
Yes, also drag and drop functionality is in the backend admin side, so and it is also not affecting the much in the load time. In the front end it will be easier to load, and it will only call the required JS, like if I require a JS for a block only, then only that part will be called in the front. Not all the JSs will be included and making the site speed slow.
Go to the site which is wordpress.org/Gutenberg, then you can look out for a page which is called Language of Gutenberg. It's the second page in the handbook. You can read that page, it will tell you exactly how Gutenberg works. And there's a lot of serialization and deserialization happens every time you repeat the post for editing and save the post. Iski wajah se aapka load time bhi badhta hai, plus what goes out in the front end is taken care of by WordPress, not you. You don't have a control over that because of the serialization. And the drag and drop right now is limited only to media because they're still trying to, that's my assumption right now, that they're still trying to fine-tune the other performance issues. That's my assumption again, that's not assumption. It's taking liberty to say that. But abhi sirf media drag and drop. Blocks drag and drop nahi hote, there's a click and it jumps one thing at the top and then you just reshuffle that.
Anyone else has any questions? Anything else you would like to say? Or I think pretty much everything is covered. So the major part is you will have to install Gutenberg. It is a plugin right now. So you'll get both the option of Classic Editor and Gutenberg Editor. The sooner you start getting used to it would be more fruitful for you as well, going forward and for the community as well, because you'll be giving the feedbacks and everything.
Thank you.